NGEx Resources has a very exciting portfolio of highly promising assets in South America. Could you tell us a little bit more about those?
Yeah, well, our core projects are Josemaria and Los Helados, and these are two of the largest junior-held copper-gold projects in the world, and certainly two of the largest ones in South America. So what's interesting about them is that there are very few junior companies that hold projects of this size and scale. We did a PEA a couple of years ago that showed that we could produce around 150,000 tons of copper per year, somewhere around 100,000 ounces of gold per year and 1.2 million ounces of silver. And that's per year for almost 50 years. And these are unique assets in a small company like NGEx.
So which of those assets are you then most excited about?
Well, in the short term, I'm really excited about Josemaria because we're planning to do a pre-feasibility study on a standalone open pit at Josemaria. And what's exciting about that is that it would be a very simple project, low strip ratio, producing a nice clean concentrate. And it's very similar to a lot of other projects that are in production in South America right now. So I'm really excited about that. We don't have to spend a lot of money. And in the next 6 months, we can produce a pre-feasibility study on what I think is going to be a really exciting project.
So the Lundin Group in general is very bullish to the copper price going forward, and I know that you share that view. Why are you so bullish?
I'm very bullish on copper, and that's really because there's a strong case to be made for strong and growing demand in copper, and that's going to be primarily driven by electric vehicles. That's part of it, but also green energy. All forms of green energy require a lot of copper, and that's both in the equipment itself and in the additional connections to the grid that are needed. So I think the demand picture for copper is excellent, and at the same time, the potential for new supply to come on the market, I think, is a lot more restricted than a lot of people think. And I think that's going to combine to create a gap, and prices are going to be stronger due to the supply-demand gap that we see coming in the next couple of years.
So what are the most important next steps for NGEx?
The big things for NGEx and the big milestones are going to be the pre-feasibility study on Josemaria, which is due the first quarter of 2019. In the shorter term, we're expecting some results from our new Nacimientos exploration project. This is a really exciting district-scale land package that has gold potential and copper-gold potential that we picked up last year. We fast-tracked that project to drilling. We did a couple of scout holes in the first quarter of this year, and we're expecting results before the end of the second quarter. So I'm really excited about that. I think that's an interesting project that has the potential to be our next big thing in Argentina.